Hallelujah. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise this morning. So magnify the Lord. Hallelujah.
I'm chasing after you.
This morning, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. Hallelujah. God, we thank you this morning. Have your way in this service. Lord, we thank you for your safety and security, Lord God. Don't let this day pass without us forgetting to give you all the glory and all of the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, God.
Awesome.
God, a hand of praise. Amen. We are standing. We are here for the welcome. Amen. Hallelujah. It looks like we're just us. It's us. So we know the roll call. We know how everything go. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's no new people in the place. Amen. So we know how everything goes. So we're just grateful that God, hallelujah, in his infinite wisdom, allowed us to be here today. Amen. Hallelujah. Prepare our hearts to get ready because we know God has a word. Amen. In the belly of our pastor. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, we just thank you. We magnify you. We lift you up. We give your name glory, Father, for your awesome, oh God. You're wonderful. You're magnificent, God. There's none that comes close or compares to you, Father. We just thank you on this day, Father, that the word that's resonating in the belly of our pastor, oh God, is right and ready, oh God, hallelujah, to help us, to uplift us, to encourage us, oh God, even bring correction, oh God, Father, for your word tells us, hallelujah, that you chasten those that you love, oh God, so wherever we be in error, oh God, chase after us, oh God, chasten us, oh God, hallelujah, that we might get right and be in right relationship and in proper alignment with you, Father, so we just thank you, oh God, that you would bless him and his family, oh God, keep him, oh God, keep his mind focused and centered on you, oh God, bless these your people, oh God, that our hearts will be open, ready to receive your word today, oh God, hallelujah, not just receive it or hear it, oh God, but apply it, oh God, hallelujah, for that's where wisdom comes and the application of your word, oh God, so we thank you, bless you, we magnify you, and it is in Jesus' name that we pray, amen and amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
hallelujah. So God, we thank you this morning, allowing us to give ourselves away.
Myself away.
life.
Take my life
as a living sacrifice. My own, to you I belong. I give myself to you. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. Give myself away.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's a sacrificial praise. It's a sacrificial worship. This is the place where you give yourself away. You just sung it. Hallelujah. Where you give yourself away. You allow God to use you in whatever capacity he chooses to use you. Hallelujah. We can't get attitudes. We can't get discombobulated. We just got to let God be God in our lives. We got to be determined that if he decides to use us, however he uses, we're willing to be used in that manner. We can't get frustrated about things not going the way we want them to go. We can't get sad by how things are not functioning, how we think they ought to function. We just got to be like water, be willing to be used however God wants to go, wherever he pushes or wherever he pulls on us. We got to be willing to be used. I know life gets tough at times, hallelujah, and there are days when you want to throw up your hands and throw in the towels, but when you throw up in your hands, just say, God, use me however you want to use me. I'm here as a living sacrifice, God, hallelujah. Let your ways be my ways. Let your thoughts become my thoughts, hallelujah. Let your desires be my desires, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give him praise. Give him glory. Magnify him. Because the simple fact is, on your job, he's using you. In your home, he's using you. Hallelujah. In any, wherever he chooses to use you at, he is using you. God has purpose and a plan for your life. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Jeremiah 29:11 reminds us of that. He has a plan, and the good thing about his plan is it's designed not to abandon us, not to make us feel forsaken, hallelujah, but his plans, hallelujah, are to prosper us, hallelujah, for us to have good godly success in him, hallelujah, to make his name great, to give him glory, to magnify him, hallelujah, through our lives. So surrender your lives to God, surrender your will, surrender your way, and watch God move fabulously in your life. Phenomenally make changes. Watch him do things that you never expected to happen. Watch things happen in your life that you didn't even see coming because you surrendered. Listen, blessings are always on the other side of obedience. So the more you obey God, the more the blessings will come. Stop looking for material things to be blessed. Sometimes it's just your health. Sometimes it's a family member getting saved. Sometimes it's a promotion on the job. But just be willing to be used by God. Be submitted and committed faithfully to wherever he's planted you, and you will see God do phenomenal things in your life. God is an outstanding father. Hallelujah. He's a phenomenal friend. He's better to you than you let known. He's better to you than anyone could ever be. Hallelujah. Because if we be real honest, the things that you did last night, last week, last month, last year disqualified us from a lot of stuff. Hallelujah. All we truly, really deserve is death, the grave, and hell. Hallelujah. But because he's merciful, he's kind. Hallelujah. But because his grace is sufficient. Hallelujah. He gives us more than we deserve. Hallelujah. Amen. So give God a shout of praise right now in this house. Somebody say hallelujah. Listen, it's through your praise where you establish the atmosphere. The Bible tells us that he inhabits the praises of his people. So when you shout unto God with the voice of triumph, when you give him praise and glory, hallelujah, you make the atmosphere conducive for God to step in and do some things. I don't know what you may have need of. I don't know what your heart's desire is. I don't know what you're going through. But I promise you, if you praise God, if you magnify him, hallelujah, don't look at your neighbor. Don't be concerned about your condition. If you just open up your mouth and give him glory, if you just magnify
by the Lord. If you will just bless his name, he will step in the midst of your situation. Hallelujah. Because that's the kind of God he is. He's a promise keeper. He's a burden bearer. Hallelujah. He is faithful and just. He is kind and true. Somebody magnify the Lord with me. Hallelujah. 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 One more time, just shout unto God with the voice of triumph. You have the victory. I know it may not look like you're winning, but listen, because you're a child of the Most High God, you're winning. You are victorious anyhow. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Amen. Amen. I am standing for announcements today. Hallelujah. January 20th, 2019. Hallelujah. If you have not already resubscribed to our text alert system, please do so by entering the number 71441 and then type PHDIM and follow the prompts. There's information that comes across that text, hallelujah, that will keep you in the loop to what's going on here at the Potter's House Dayton International Ministries. Amen. Join us every Thursday for noonday Bible study. Pastor, one of the elders may be teaching it. Amen. Hallelujah. And it's a way to get refreshed. Amen. And it's also a time where you can ask questions. Amen. You might have heard something preached across the pulpit on Sunday, and it might have been you might have been wrestling with it all week long, and now you get in the presence of the person that spoke that word. Amen. You can ask, hey, give me clarity on this. Amen. So it's a good thing if you're in the vicinity. Amen. You got an hour lunch or so, or you're not doing anything at that hour, you're off of work that day, just stop by here 12 noon. Amen. And allow God to refresh your spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. All ministries are seeking assistance. Hallelujah. All ministries. Remember, it's a heart thing. We want your heart to be right. Make sure God is drawing you to it. Amen. Let it become a desire, a thing, a burden that you feel like I gotta do. Hallelujah. If I don't do it, it won't get done. Let it rest upon you like that. Hallelujah. Because that way you'll bless the ministry. You'll be a help. Amen. Hallelujah. You'll be willing to do it. When you feel like it's a burden on you, that you got to get it done. If you don't do it, it won't get done. Then you'll do it. Amen. Hallelujah. We don't want you just to come. Now, let me put this out there. There may be times where the ministry may ask for help. Please come and help, because it may just be set up and tear down. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. It may be staying at a station for a couple of hours. It may be serving on a certain day. Amen. That doesn't disqualify you from, or that doesn't say that you're a part of that ministry. That just says on that day you're helping. Amen. We need volunteers on these days. Amen. So please come. Amen. But I'm talking about if you really want to join this ministry, it's been on your heart. You've been just thinking about it. Amen. And seek the Lord. Make sure it's God's will for you, and you'll be a blessing to that ministry. And that ministry will be a blessing to your life. Amen. Super Bowl Sunday, February 3rd. Wear your favorite team jersey. Amen. It doesn't have to be football. It could be baseball, basketball, hockey, cricket, whatever. Whatever your favorite sport is, it could be polo, whatever. Just wear it on that day. That's our Jersey Sunday. Amen. February 3rd. Please continue to pray for the sick and shut-in and the bereaved families. Amen. Keep them lifted, even if you don't know what's happening. Cry out unto God to heal, deliver, and set free and bring comfort. God knows who's going through. Amen. January is Cervical Cancer Awareness Month. We will be wearing the color teal next Sunday. That's a combination of blue and green. Or you just saying wear blue and green. So wear teal, blue, or green. Wear teal, blue, or green. Or it's a combination of blue and green mix. I don't know, but just wear teal, blue, or green. Amen. On next Sunday to represent our awareness of cervical cancer. And on this coming Tuesday, my mother's homegoing services will be here at 11 a.m. Those that are available, my family and myself will greatly appreciate it if you can come and assist in any capacity. Amen. We will greatly, greatly, greatly appreciate it. Hallelujah. Birthdays and anniversaries. Sherry Martin's birthday was last week. Amen. She turned 25. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. She said she turned 25. I told her she was lying, but she said
she said. She said, you ain't got my birth certificate. Amen. So what did I can say? Amen. Hallelujah. But her birthday was this past week. Amen. Amen. So listen. Oh, he ain't in the building yet. Listen. Pastor Martha's 60th birthday is February 9th. Amen. Amen. So, we're going to put something together. Hallelujah. First Lady, we're going. February 8th, First Lady's is February 8th. So, why you in the building? We're talking lines, so we got to put something together. Just can't let them know, but they going to know that she in the building now. And so, we'll do something. They just want to know what it is. They just know it's something. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So, February 8th, February 9th. Remember those dates? Pastor and First Lady. Amen. We're going to celebrate them. Hallelujah. So at this time, there's no more birthdays, anniversaries. Hug your neighbor. Oh. Her birthday is this coming Friday. Okay, amen. Sister Cora's birthday is this coming Friday. Amen. She turned 26. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We give him glory. We thank God for all these birthdays and God adding another year to your life. Amen. So at this time, we would ask that you would hug your neighbor, greet your neighbor with a holy kiss, and let them know that this is the day.
Yeah.
Give God some praise in the house. Hallelujah. The song said, and we are glad. Yes, we are glad. And we are glad. Yes, we are glad. Is there anybody in here that's glad this morning? Glad that he woke you up. Glad that he started you on your way. Glad that he allowed you to come into the house of worship. Hallelujah. We're glad. Yes, we are glad. On a snowy, cold, icy morning, we glad. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Hallelujah. God bless you this morning for coming out in the elements. Amen. Hallelujah. We thank God for this opportunity. Amen. Hallelujah. God is so good to me. Hallelujah. Amen. If you pray with me, pray for me. Amen. We'll get through this real quickly and go home. There. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to thank God for this opportunity to bring the word this morning. I want to thank my pastor for allowing me to share with the house, with the Lord and saying, amen. We give honor to our pastor, Lady Moss, this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Whatever you're doing, just leave it right there. I don't need nothing else. Amen. Amen. We thank God. Hallelujah for help. I said, we thank God for help. Amen. I got help upstairs. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you. We glorify you. We magnify you. We bless your name. We thank you for this opportunity. Now we ask that this word might minister to your people, that it might encourage, God, that it might warn, that it might even move someone out of their comfort zone. Most of all, we pray, Lord, that this word would change them, that they won't leave out the same way that they came in, but that it might be a blessing to them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Ephesians 6th chapter, starting at the 12th verse. When you found it, say amen. King James Word. And it reads, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girded about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Amen. 2 Kings 6th chapter, 15th through the 16th verse in the NIV. When the servant of the man of God got up and went out early the next morning, an army with horses and chariots had surrounded the city. He cried, O Lord, O my Lord, what shall we do? The servant asked. Verse 16 says, don't be afraid, the prophet answered. Those who are with us are more than those who are with them. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his word. Amen. For a title this morning, I can and I won't be defeated. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands and celebrate that right there. I can and I won't be defeated. Hallelujah. The enemy is busy. I said, the enemy is busy. As we look at this news and this television, we see that the weather has affected so many people all up and down the Northeast, even in going back south, some parts west. Weather, you just got natural disasters and things are happening and people are
without homes and without power. They struggling. They scrambling. They feeling pressure. Is it anybody in here feeling pressure this morning? And then to make it worse, we got to sit here and debate in politics about a wall over a paycheck. We got to debate about a wall and people trying to get legal citizenship. The enemy is busy. We look at this and some people say, this is crazy. But I come to tell you this morning, don't get wearied. If he's done it for you before, he can do it again. You need to just tell yourself, it's only a test. It'll be over in a little while. Just take time to think about how he's brought you out, how he's brought you through, and how he's carried you over the last situation. I'm gonna park right there for a few seconds and let somebody think about that. You went to the doctor and you got to the report and it didn't look good. But God worked it out. He performed a miracle right before the doctor's eyes. I said, you went to get the mail and the bill didn't look like you wanted to look, and you couldn't find money in none of your pockets and none of your envelopes and none of your stash spots. But somehow you went to the bank and there was something in your account. If he's done it once, he'll do it again. So I just come to tell somebody this morning, I can't and I won't be defeated. We look at our lives and our situations and you might want to give up. But that's not an option today. For those that believe in the God that I serve, he's able to do above and beyond you what you can even imagine or think. So there is no way we can throw in the towel. There's no way we can give up knowing that he is our God. But my life scripture tells me this, Proverbs 3:5-7, to trust in the Lord with all your heart, and to lean not to your own understanding, but in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Too much has been depending on our own understanding, and it has taken us further than we wanted to go, kept us longer than we wanted to stay, and made us pay more than we was willing to pay. You got to learn in this season to trust and depend on the Lord. Pastor Moss shared with us that it's wartime. It's time for some of us to lock up and load up. You got to be prepared in this season that when you see the enemy, you recognize the enemy. That when you see the enemy, you cut the enemy's head off. That when you see the enemy, you let him know that you're not playing games with him no more. Hallelujah. Maybe some of you that had to let some people go or become disconnected with friends that, or people that you thought was your friends. This may have been the year that you had to just reevaluate who was in your personal space. He said that this year would be the most incredible year of our lives. I don't know about you, if you really understand the ramifications of what that's saying, if this is going to be one of the most incredible years of our lives, you got to understand and recognize that this is also going to be one of the most tough years of our lives, because the enemy is going to try everything in hell to keep you from getting your manifestation. But I come to tell somebody, believe God for the big things this morning. I come to tell somebody to take a risk on something today. Do something that you've never done for the Lord before. Go out and just share a witness to somebody that you don't know and watch God show up on your behalf. And the little scripture that you think you know, you're going to be surprised, because he's going to put something on the inside that's going to help you as you witness to somebody of his goodness. That's all you got to do, is share the goodness of Jesus with somebody. Just tell them how he brought you out. Tell them how he made a way out of no way for you. Tell them how he keeps doing it over and over and over again. I'm looking around the room and I'm seeing so many examples of people that I know that it was but God. I'm looking at people and I'm seeing people that all we really should be saying to them, had it not been for God. I can look over here and some people that can say, he did it again. See, I'm in that space. I'm in that place right now in my life where I'm getting ahead of myself. But I've learned how to encourage myself in the Lord, Minister Chelsea. See, when you've seen bottom for so long, there's only one place to do. Look up. This is the year you got to choose to let go. Let him go. Let her go. Let it go. Look at your neighbor and say, I think you better let it go. I think you better let it go. Because if you don't, Teddy P said it might be a TKO. I don't know about you this morning, but I'm tired of taking TKOs from the enemy. I'm tired of getting knocked out by the enemy over some dumb stuff. Some stuff that I'm supposed to know about, that I should have learned about the first time. Some stuff that we keep going around and around the mulberry bush doing the same old things, entertaining the same old foolishness. At some point, God, you got to help me grow up and help my unbelief. I'm just trying to encourage somebody this morning, because I can't and I won't be defeated. Can't and I won't be defeated. 1 Corinthians 15 and 58 tells me that, therefore, my brother, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounded in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. And just encourage yourself right now. Just go on and begin to talk to yourself. It's okay. We won't commit you. We won't tell nobody. Just go on and encourage yourself. Remind yourself of how good God has been to you. Remind yourself of the things that he's brought you out. Remind yourself this morning that it was God that did it for you. It was God that made a way for you. I'm sitting here and I'm looking at my notes and I'm saying that I couldn't have made it without you, Jesus. I'm sitting here looking and saying, it looked real bad in 2018, but I can't and I won't be defeated. Battles came my way. Health was tactic, but I can't and I won't be defeated. Struggles with some addictions and some things that kept me taking steps back, but I had to tell myself, I can't and I won't be defeated. I might have slipped, dipped, and tripped sometimes, but I can't and I won't be defeated. Made costly mistakes, but I can't and I won't be defeated. I had some setbacks, but I can't and I won't be defeated. God's doing something new in this place, and you need to catch on and get it into your veins. Just tell somebody, I can't and I won't be defeated. He's using you to get some glory. Somebody's watching and see how you handling your situation and how you handling what you're going through and what you're going to do. Are you going to fall out and have a pity party, or are you going to begin to keep your hands lifted saying, God, I trust you. I believe in you, God. I believe that you can make a way out of no way. Just like you did for the children of Israel when they was at the Red Sea. They had the enemy behind them, and they had an ugly situation in front of them. But you made a way out of no way. Sometimes we just got to recognize that he is still in control. The devil has power on the earth, but God has power in heaven and the earth. He can do whatever he want to do, when he want to do it. Somebody's watching you, Potter's House, Dayton. Somebody's watching you, saint of God. What would your example be to the person that's watching you? When the enemy comes to sift you as wheat, when he comes as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour, what will your testimony be to those that are looking at you? Isaiah tells us and gives us a good example of what to do. Isaiah 40:31, it says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. See, you got to go above. You got to go above your problem. Somebody will get that by the time they get home. See, the ego does not get confused when the storm comes. He does not get confused when it gets dark in his life. But what he does is he flaps his wings and he goes up above the storm. Is there anybody in here today that got a storm in your life? I dare you to raise up today as an eagle and go above your storm. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. In this season, you're going to have to get yourself together. Some of us may have to go to the spiritual gym and begin to get on the treadmill and get our legs together, get our stamina built up. You might have to go and get on the elliptical machine and begin to work your arms and your legs. You got to work the whole body in this season. Every joint supplieth. Can't be broke down in the enemy on your tail. Won't have time for falling out. Won't have time for passing out. Won't have time for you crying. We don't have time for you pouting. Look at your neighbor and say, get yourself together. Because I can't and I won't be defeated. Too many times we too busy carrying wounded soldiers along. And I know it's the honorable thing to do not to leave a wounded soldier behind. But at some point I need for you to stay right there in that foxhole with that gun. And if you see anything coming your way, you shoot it. I got to go get us some help. I'm no good to you. If you wounded and I can't get us no help out of here. We got to watch out. Got to be careful this season, this next move. I remember years ago, Bishop gave us, he preached a message and shared some things with us and allowed me to be able to think on and add on to it. And he told us some things. And one thing I want to remind us is that we got to watch out for the lazy sheep and the stubborn goats. I'm talking about the people that want to be seen. Lazy sheep and stubborn goat, you know, they want to get right in the front and just lay there. They don't want to do nothing. They don't nothing move them. Don't nothing excite them. They're not in the rush to get anything done. They don't want to go any further. The rest of the sheep and the sheep are moving along and whatnot, and they decided that it's time for them to take a break. They don't want to go to Bible class because they think they got it already. They get tired every other step of the way. We encourage you to come help us do ministry here at the church, and we still waiting on you. They always can find an excuse why they can't be here. Somebody even made an excuse this morning, I can't drive in that weather. But the real sheep knows the shepherd's voice. The real sheep hears the sound of the bell of the staff as he walks, and they know to follow the shepherd. They don't go off on their own and do their own thing. I'm talking about real sheep. See, the goat is stubborn. He gonna buck. He gonna buck just to see if how far he can go or how she can go. That's dangerous. That's dangerous because what happens is they become so cocky that they get their head caught in the thorns. Then the shepherd got to come and cut the thorns and get them out to save them. I'm just come to let somebody know that the devil is real, and he'll use anything and anybody to get you distracted from the shepherd's voice. Now, I'm going to say that again. The devil is real, and he'll use anything and anybody to distract you from hearing the shepherd's voice. So don't be confused by these people that think they know more than the shepherd. They got a better way than the shepherd. See, first in the natural, the sheep in the natural can't see well. So, and the reason why they can't see well is because the shepherd put salves on their eyes so that the flies won't get in their eyes and cause infection. But some of you have been entertaining the fly. See, the fly comes and wants to show you stuff, and you entertain it by looking at it, and you wiping the salve off that the shepherd has put on. But when you do that, it causes infection. Same thing in your ears. He puts the salves on the ears so the flies won't eat on your ears and causes you to get infection. And what you do, you go rub up against something to get the salve off. Now you got an ear infection. You got all kind of noisily pestilence in your ear. The devil is real. Be careful who you're allowed to get in your eye gates and your ear gates. So knowing that, we got to always be mindful that the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. He comes seeking to kill and destroy. He comes to seek your mind and kill your dreams. He comes to destroy your future. He comes to seek your health and to kill your bodies and to destroy your testimonies. He comes to seek the truth and to kill your finances and to destroy your connections. He comes to seek your faith, see how much faith you got, and to kill your prayers and to destroy your covenant. He comes to seek your kids, to kill their beliefs and to destroy their destiny. But I'm telling you, I can't and I won't be defeated. That's why we got to be prayed up. We got to pray without ceasing. I read that scripture and then I began to do the study. And what I found out in the Greek, that when it says to pray without ceasing in the Greek, that means continuously. That don't mean perpetually, but it means continuously. It may be that you're praying right now and you take a minute and you do something, and then you go back into prayer. But it's a continuous prayer. It's almost like a prescription that the doctor gives you. Every six times a day, you need to take this. If you don't take it, it'll mess you up. It'll cause you from being well. How many of us are taking the prescription that God has given us? I'm almost done, y'all. This next warning, this is the thing that God gave me. This next warning, he told me that we need to be careful and watch out about mouthy midgets and pious peacocks. Mouthy midgets and pious peacocks. Now, don't get it misunderstood. But a mouthy midget ain't always a short person. A mouthy midget, that you just got the mouthy midget mentality, because the mouthy midget, even though he's short, he thinks he's bigger than everybody. He thinks he can tell everybody what to do. Opinionated, always challenging authority, finding it hard to follow assignments, complaining about everything, never seeing or having a solution, trying to be big when little got him. Talk a good game, but can't never deliver. Telling Pastor, say, Pastor, I got your back, and he's still waiting for you to show up. That's that mouthy midget. So somebody might want to examine themselves today. You might want to just take a self-evaluation. Lord, am I the mouthy midget? And then we have this pious peacock walking around trying to be seen and looking down at others, saying that they're there for ministry but never have time to feed the communities, to visit the sick, to go to the jails, to clean the church, but I always got a word for somebody. Don't listen well to leadership, but always a distraction. Don't worry, God has sent us what we need for these type of people. He's sending us a solution. The first solution is prayer. But God showed it to me in a reverse way. He showed it to me this way. You got to watch, fight, and pray. And I said he showed it to me in reverse because I got prayer, fight, and watch. But really, you got to watch and see where your enemy coming from. Some of you who ever had to be in situations where you didn't know where your enemy was coming from, you know what I'm saying. Sometimes you don't even open your mouth and say nothing. You just sit back and watch and see who coming in the door, who leaving. You're coming, you're watching, you see who's talking and who ain't talking. You listen and hear what they saying and what they not saying. You're watching. In this season, we got to have some people that are willing to watch. Got to, and Bishop shared it with us in the buddy system. You got to know where the enemy is. And in order for you to know where the enemy is, you got to be watching, listening, and praying. Praying for what? Praying for discernment. God, give me discernment to know when this enemy is showing up. Hallelujah. And then I'm gonna help somebody here. This is why you got to be fit in the natural and in the spirit. In this season, we're gonna be doing some fight. Pastor already said we at war. And I don't know about y'all, but I already had to fight a couple of them. I had to fight a couple of wars already. And it's just January 20th. We got 11 more months to go. Did you hear what I just said? We got 11 more months to go. Don't you think the enemy gonna give up? Don't you think he's not gonna try to stop us from getting to our goal, that he's gonna try to stop you from manifesting, that he's gonna try to stop you from reaching the mark that's been set? This is the real thing. As a church, as a ministry, as a body of believers, don't you think he's not going to come against the Potter's House Dayton? That's why we got to be here. That's why we got to get the proper training with Thai class, foundation class. We got to be here. Let me help some of y'all out that have already went through those. BWV is coming back, so you might as well get your Saturday morning ready. Might as well get it ready. We got to continue to get this thing in our spirit. We got to continue to get built up. You know what? I'm parking right here for a second. I'm thinking about how soldiers do. They go to boot camp before they get into the service, but they never stop working on proper tactics and training their bodies and maneuverabilities and things like that. They always working up a new way to be prepared to fight the enemy. The enemy don't keep doing the same thing. He come a different way. Almost to the text here. We're going to get on out of here. You got to pray. You got to pray without ceasing. Your prayer life has got to be real. It has got to be real. Because the devil gonna know. If we ain't got nothing to throw at him when he coming, he gonna just eat you up. You got to get in that word, and you got to be able to say something back to him. And then, could I help you out? He also knows who for real and who ain't for real. He know who the fake Christian is. He know the fake Christian. He know the one that's saying I'm a Christian and I'm saved. But he know when you leave out these church doors, how many times you opened up your Bible. He knows how many times that you really sat down and prayed and waited on an answer or waited on him to come back to you. He knows how many times that you've really done the things that he's asked you to do as a saved believer. And he's going to try you. So you can try to fool us if you want to. We'll be waiting for you. We'll be waiting to pray you back through. Because it's going to show up. If you're not in your word, if you're not praying, it's going to show up. So we have here the prophet and the servant. 2 Kings 6, from the 8th to the 23rd verse, we have them here. And they got a situation going on. They got a situation going on. First of all, you got a king of Aram was at war with Israel, and after confirming with his officers, he said, I set up a camp in such a place. Verse 9, it said, the man of God sent word that the king of Israel, he sent this word to the king of Israel, said, beware of passing that place, because the Amorites are going down there. So the king of Israel checked on the place indicated by the man of God. Time and again, Elisha warned the king so that he was on his guard in such a place. I'm telling somebody right now that the devil coming, and you need to be ready. I'm telling somebody right now that if you do not pay attention to what the man of God is warning you, that you're about to run into an ambush. The man of God kept telling them, don't go down in that place. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning. Well, wherever the place was that you was going that you don't need to go, I'm telling you today, don't go in that place. If that place is going to cause you to slip, don't go there. If that place is going to cause you your faith to be tried, don't go there. That's not the place for you to be going. Don't pass through there. So he asked, none of us, my lord the king, said no one of his officers. But Elijah the prophet, who is in Israel, tell the king of Israel the very words you speak in this bedroom. Verse 13 says, go find out where he is, the king ordered, so I can send men to capture him. The report came back. He is in Dothan or Dothan. Then he sent horses and chariots and strong forces there. They went by night and surrounded the city. Can I help you out? The enemy don't play fair. See, while you sleeping, he's sending his enemies to come to take you out. While you not paying attention, he's sending the enemies to come to sift you as wheat. Well, while you relaxing and chilling, he got his enemies on. He got the enemies on the way. In one version, it said it was a mighty force, a strong army. I mean, this was a big army, and they was ready to come and take everything, take him out. So, verse 15, when the servant of the man of God got up and went out early the next morning, an army with horses and chariots had surrounded the city. It says, oh no, my lord, what shall we do? The servant asked. How many of y'all have had to say that? Oh Lord, what am I going to do? Or how many of you have said this? Oh, Lord, what you going to do? Because this thing got real now. It's not just one of them. It's a whole group of them, and they surrounded the whole city. What you going to do? That's what the servant said to the king. to his master. My question would be, what you gonna do? Because we both in this thing together. I ain't getting no amens right there. You ask me what I'm gonna do. What you gonna do? We in this thing together. They surrounding both of us right now. And that goes back to what I was saying. You know, unless you wounded and you can't help me, you better be ready to fight too. Amen. So just like a father, just like the man of God, he said, don't be afraid. See, when you got the Holy Ghost behind you, you ain't got to get afraid of when things don't look good. All you got to do is trust and believe in the God that you believe in. Somebody here act like God done something for them. Verse 16 says this: "Don't be afraid," the prophet answered. "Those who are with us are more than those who are with them." And now, ain't that an encouraging word this morning? I don't know what you're going through or what you're dealing with, but I'm glad to know that my Father has told me that those that are with us are more than those that are with the enemy. Then look what he just said. And Elijah prayed. See, you got to know what to do when the enemy is all around you. You got to know what to do when things look tight, when things look like you ain't going to be able to get out of it. You got to know what to do. He said he prayed. He prayed for the servant. He said, "Open his eyes so he can see what I see." See, the problem with some of us is we get afraid because we can't see what God is trying to show us. We only can see what the naked eye is showing us. It says, "Open your eye, open his eyes, Lord, so that he might see." Then the Lord opened the servant's eyes, and he looked and saw a hill full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elijah. Now, isn't that a wonderful sight? You see the enemy right here in front of you. But when you look again, you see all around the enemy horses and chairs of fire. I got about 2-3 people that's excited and begin to recognize that the thing I'm going through right now don't look that bad. Now that God has showed me that he's great and mighty, that he's mighty in battle. That he showed me he's the big-breasted one. That thing that it looked like it was about to take me out of, he just came to my rescue again and showed me, and he's making a way out of no way. And as the enemy came down towards Elijah prayed to the Lord and said, "Strike this army with blindness." So he struck them with blindness as Elijah asked. Isn't it wonderful when you can talk to your daddy and he don't wait on the, he don't take his time in that situation when you need the most, but he come quicker than right now. I'm going to come on this side over here. Maybe somebody could testify that you needed help right now. And you cried out to the Lord and said, "Lord, come and help me. I need you right now." Did he show up? Elijah cried out and prayed, said, "Strike this army with blindness." So he struck them with blindness, and Elijah said, "If you ask and believe by faith and his will, he'll bring it to pass." I got about 3 people over here that can believe that this morning. I'm talking about somebody that needs something. I'm talking about, did you need something that only God can give you? Elijah told him, "This is not the road, and this is not the city. Follow me, and I will lead you to the man you're looking for." And he led them to Samaria. Look here. The Lord will confuse your enemies and cause them to not to come to harm you. What he said, I like the way he said it, and Simon said, he'll make your enemies your footstool. He'll set a table before you right in the presence of your enemy. And that enemy that will come to try to kill you, he allowed them to be able to come, not just kill, to come to kill you, but now they're coming to serve you. I'm trying to help somebody here. You thought this enemy was coming to kill you, but this enemy is coming to serve you this morning. God has confused them. Verse 20 says, and after they entered into the city, Elisha said, "Open, Lord, open the eyes of these men so they can see." Then the Lord opened their eyes and they looked, and they were inside. See here, look here. They came to kill the man of God. The man of God prayed to God the Father. God the Father heard his prayer. Not only did he blind the enemy, but he sent the enemy off into the place of their enemy. Did you hear what I just said? When you got a relationship and a connection with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, when you speak, something should happen. I'm going to say it again. When you got a relationship with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords and you say something, something should happen. That's how I was so able to say it this morning. Like I said, I can't and I won't be defeated. I'm tired of the enemy defeating me. So as a result of that, I'm taking a stand. I'm not taking no more whoopings. I'm not taking no more defeats. I'm not getting knocked out no more. I'm coming with everything I got. I've been in the gym working out. I've been studying the enemy's moves. I've been sitting back watching the tapes of how he got me last time. I was looking for the right, but he came with the left jab. He ain't gonna get me like that again. I was looking at how he acted like he was gonna throw a punch, but he kicked me and made me go down. I'm not gonna be fall for that one again. I was supposed to be working out, getting ready for the fight, and what did I do? I allowed the enemy to introduce me to what a cheeseburger tastes like. You see how the enemy works? He ain't playing fair. He's not playing fair. He gets you right where it hurts. The thing that you love the most, he'll use it. I'm going to say it again. The thing that you love the most, he'll use it. He'll use her. He'll use him. You know the story. It says, those that was closest to me that I took counsel with, sweet counsel with, that's the one that the enemy want to use. Come get the one that's closest to you, that you shared your intimate secrets with. Then use them. See what your faith is like. Look how gracious and look how loving Elisha is. He said, don't kill him. Don't kill him. He answered, would you kill those you have captured with your own sword and or bow? He said, set food and water before them so that they may eat and drink and then go back to their master. So he prepared a great feast for them. And after he had finished eating and drinking, he sent them away and they returned back to their master. So the band of Aram's stopped riding Israel territory. What am I saying? When you let God fight your battle, you ain't got to worry about your enemies coming back no more. As long as you keep trying to do it yourself, they're gonna keep coming. It's like the big bully when you was a little kid or that you used to see. The big bully kept coming back as long as he knew that you couldn't do nothing or that you weren't afraid or that you was afraid of him. He kept coming back. But the moment that you stood up to the bully The moment that you showed the bully that I'm not taking no more butt whoopings from you. The moment that you showed the bully, you're not taking my lunch today. The moment that you showed the bully, you know what? You might get me today, but I'm not giving up without a fight. Somebody in here needs something from the Lord. I mean, you really need something. I sent you all a song up there. But Amos, you said it. Well, maybe actually, you reminded us. It was prophesied to us that this is a house of prayer. And I saw something. I witnessed something with my own eyes while I was away. There's somebody in here today that need God to do something. It might be three or four of y'all, but it's one person particularly that really need God to do something. Raise your hand. Don't be afraid. You're right there. Come here. Let me show you how this thing is going to work. Stand right there for me, sis. Do you believe that God can do it today? You believe that He can make a way out of no way for you? I need four ladies over here to come surround her. Come on. Just four. Don't touch her yet, mama. Lady moms, don't touch her yet. Y'all link up. Hold hands. Come this way, LJ. Link up. Now, while she's believing what she's believing God for, I need y'all to pray for her. Because the enemy's going to come. And when he comes, you got to have some support that's going to keep him from getting in. You got to have some people with some power that could keep him from coming in to attack you from the back. Are y'all getting this? See, the enemy don't play fair and he don't care. So, but as long as you got a prayer partner, as long as you got somebody that's believing with you, as long as you got somebody I'm standing in intercession for you. When you can't pray for yourself, I'm going to pray for you. Because see, along the line, it might get hard, but you got to still believe. Though he slay me, would I trust him? So while they praying for you, just going to lift your hands up. You are under arrest. You are under arrest. And right now, you need to surrender everything that you got, everything that you have, everything that's been bothering you, everything that's been coming against you. You need to surrender it right now to this altar. And you need to believe that God is about to do it on your behalf. You need to believe that God is going to change it around. You need to believe that God is going to make a way out of no way. Come on, ladies. I need to hear you praying for it. I need to hear you praying for it. Who was my other person that had that needed it? Who was the other person that needed a miracle? Who was it? Come on, I see your hand up back there. Come on. I need four more people to come on and surround her. Come on, ladies. Come on. Don't wait. Move now. Come on. She said she needed a miracle. I need you to be in a standing in agreement with her. Come on, surround her. Pray. Come on. I need another lady. Come on, mama. Come on. I got four. Come on. Who else? Who else needed a miracle? Come on. I need that song. I don't know what's taking it so long. This is a house of prayer. Come on. Anybody else here? Find somebody. Come on. I need four guys to surround them and pray for them. Come on. Don't be afraid. Don't be scared. Come on. Is it anybody else in here? Anybody else in here need a miracle? You need God to move on your behalf. Come on to the altar while he's here. Hallelujah. Come on, Demisha, you need it. Come on, ladies. Come on, y'all, pray for her. Come on. Hallelujah. It don't matter. Come on.
Come on, Brother Kurt. You need prayer? Okay, come on. Surround her. Y'all pray. Y'all surround her. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let heaven hear you this morning. Let heaven hear you this morning. Hallelujah. Let heaven hear you this morning. Hallelujah. Not by might, but by your spirit, Lord. By your spirit, move this morning. This is a house of prayer. We will not leave out the same way that we came in. Hallelujah. 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 I need somebody else. Come on. Now we're going to transfer this thing. Somebody else jump in. Somebody else jump in. Get in, LJ. They're going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let God move in your life today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Somebody else in this group over here that need a miracle. Come on. You stay right there with them, mama. Come on, come on. There you go. There you go. Come on, pray. Come on. Come on, somebody else take the middle. Come on, somebody else take the middle. Don't be afraid. Take the middle. There you go. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody else over here. Step in the middle. Come on, step out. Let somebody else in. There you go. Let him in. Come on, pray for him. Come on, cover him right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on, Demetria. Let somebody else get this miracle. Come on. Hallelujah. Let somebody, come on, pray. Let him hear you praying. Hallelujah. We thank you today, God. We thank you today, God, for what you're about to do in this place. We thank you today, God. We thank you today, God. Hallelujah. Let your spirit move right now in the name of Jesus. We don't do it for show or fashion, God, but we stand in the need of prayer. We stand in the need of you moving. Hallelujah. Those of you that's out there in the congregation, grab somebody's hand next to you. Begin to pray with them. Begin to move. Begin to believe God for their healing. Believe God for their miracle. Believe God for a blessing. Come on. Come on, all over the sanctuary. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. This is a house of prayer. This is a house of prayer. Hallelujah. He's answering the prayers of the righteous. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all, switch over here. Get in the middle, Janini. Come on, come on. Switch up, switch up. Come on, get in the middle. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, believe him for your turnaround. Believe him for your turnaround right now. Believe him for your turnaround. Come on, switch. Switch, 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 switch. Let somebody else in. Let somebody else in. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Pray, saints. Pray, saints. Don't let it be in vain. Don't let them be here needing God to move. And you give up on. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, Zion. Let him hear you today. Hallelujah. 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 God is moving. He's a healer, even if the world don't believe it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We come against everything that would try to take us out. We come against diabetes. We come against cancer. We come against breast cancer, any type of illness that would cause our bodies to deteriorate. We come against the enemy addictions right now, God. Deliver us from the inside out, God. Let your blood run right now, Jesus, and cover us, oh God. We thank you in advance for your blood that was shed on Calvary's cross, oh God. Hallelujah. Heal your people, God. Set your people free right now in the name of Jesus. Have your way in this place today, God. Show your power in this place. Let everyone that came in, oh God, be healed by your blood, oh God. Be set free by your blood, oh God. We thank you in advance that they won't leave out the same way that they came in. But today, God, that you have done it, oh God. Today, oh God, you making things happen for them. Today, oh God, we lift them up to you, God, and we pray right now that you would have your way. Hallelujah. Come on, Zion, let the Lord hear you today. Let him hear you today, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't get tired. Don't get tired. Come on, don't get tired. Come on, let that be your prayer today. Let the altar of my heart never burn out. Hallelujah. Make this a house of prayer. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, give God some praise right there. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Come on, celebrate. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Come on, thank him like he's already done it. Come on, celebrate like he's already turned it around. Celebrate that he's already worked a miracle on your behalf. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Come on, find somebody. Find somebody. Don't be afraid to ask them if they need prayer. They might not want to come to the front. Come on, cover them, cover them, cover them. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on, love on to cover them. Protect them. Protect them. Come on. Don't be afraid to ask them. That tear in the back. Come here, tear. Come here. I know you don't like it, but come on. You too precious to the kingdom. Come on. Mama LJ. Mrs. Chelsea, come on, pray with her. She's too precious to the kingdom. Come on, I need somebody that know how to pray with her. Pray for her. Come on, cover her. I want nobody to leave out uncovered. I don't want nobody to leave out uncovered. Come on, I want nobody to leave out uncovered. Somebody go over there and pray with Debbie. She's been worshiping the Lord, but somebody go pray with her. Go pray with her. I want nobody uncovered. Come on, let God use you today like never before. Come on. Let him get the victory. Let him get the victory. Hallelujah. Let him get the victory. He's worthy of the praise. He's worthy of the praise. He's worthy of the praise. Hallelujah. He's worthy of the praise. Come on, let him use you, Zion. Let him use you. While we're in this atmosphere, while we're in this atmosphere, come on, let God move. Let God move. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Make us a house of prayer. Hallelujah. God, if you find anything that shouldn't be, take it out right now, God. Make us white as snow. Oh God, we love you today. We magnify you today, God. We want to be right, God. We want to be right, God. We want to be right, God. Make us a house of prayer. Hallelujah. Make us a house of prayer, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let the fire of my altar never burn out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Make me a house. Make me a house of prayer. Hallelujah.
I want to seek your face, oh Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. A house of prayer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, Zion. Come on, believe in Jesus. Come on. Come on, let him use you today. Let him use you today like never before. Come on, cry out to him. Dig deep, dig deep. Come on, dig deep. Cry out for him today. Come on, he's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think. He's able to do anything. Come on, Zion. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. Come on and worship him. Make this a house of prayer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We surrender all today, God. We surrender all to you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah. Make this a house, God. Make this a house of prayer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. We thank you. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Come on, come on. Come on, everybody. Come on, come on. Let him hear you. Let him hear you. Let him hear you. Let him hear you. If you need it today, don't leave here the same way you came. Come on, Zion. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, day and night, night and day. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Make this a house of prayer. Hallelujah. We love you, God. We love you, God. We love you, God. We love you, God. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, if you believe God, if you believe this thing that turned around for you, if you believe in him for your victory, come on and celebrate right there. Come on, I want to hear you, Zion. I want to hear you. Come on. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Hallelujah. Come on, celebrate like he's already done it. Celebrate like he's already done it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, give God some praise right there. Come on, celebrate him like he's done that thing for you. Celebrate it like he's done it for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. That's my prayer for everyone here today, that we never leave out of here the same way that we came in, but that we would have experienced his presence. Don't ever come in the house of God burdened and leave out with the burden. Don't ever come in the house of God expecting healing and not leave out healed. Don't ever come in the house of God expecting him to move on your behalf and you not seek his face. Hallelujah. That's it. Call his name. Call his name. Call his name. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. Whatever you need today, whatever you need, I come against depression in the name of Jesus. I come against suicide in the name of Jesus. Arthritis, blood pressure, I come against it in the name of Jesus. Loneliness, abandonment, I come against it in the name of Jesus. Addiction and worrying, I come against it in the name of Jesus. Come on, saints. And this next season, we can't leave out of church the same way that we came in. You ain't got to promise me that, but at least tell God, God, help me not come in one way and leave out the same way. I can't, and I won't be defeated. You need to tell yourself that from now on. I can't, and I won't be defeated. Hallelujah. Come on, Pastor.
Come on, put your hands together and give God a praise for the man of God. Hallelujah. I need four brothers to grab, get around him, circle him up, and stretch your hands this way and pray for the man of God. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Keep giving God praise.